tough act to follow. God bless America. Thank you for coming out today. Thank you for standing alongside a fellow patriots. No matter what the numbers are, you're in the number. And remember, at the beginning of this country, there was just a handful of men and women who decided that they didn't want to live under the tyranny of the Brits anymore. And they declared their independence and they fought for their independence. And I have to tell you, my message to you today is, what's it going to look like on July 4th next year? What's the United States of America going to look like? Are we still going to be able to gather on street corners? Are we going to be able to keep at least most of the money that we earn and to take care of our families? Or next year, are we going to be banned from street corners? Are we going to have kill switches on the internet? These are the important questions for you to answer. And a good friend of mine who will be speaking in just a few moments said something the other day that I want to use as my theme. Yesterday was July 2nd. In 4 months, we will have the most important election of our lifetimes. On November 2nd, you have to make a decision. Do you want to be here next year holding up signs that say, thank you, patriots. Thank you to the men and women we've sent to Congress who have put the brakes on this insanity that's been happening for the last 19 months. Do you want to be here cheering or do you want to be gone? That's the decision you have to make. And you have 4 months in which to accomplish a very lofty goal. You've got to get rid of these people in Washington who have no integrity. You have to begin to put your money and your talent where your mouths are. It's not enough to stand on street corners. We've got to be knocking on doors, waking people up, getting into conversations that are tough to have. Yes, we all have friends and family who got all swept up in hope and change, and they're having a really tough time admitting what a big mistake they made. It's our job to talk about what's really happening in America, and we have 4 months in which to get that message out there. If you want a 4th of July that still involves saying the pledge and singing the national anthem and waving flags proudly, you're going to have to do something different this year. You're going to have to get other people involved in this fight. I look around and I'm proud of the people who showed up today, but there should be 20 times this many people standing on every street corner in every city in America today, because we are facing the most important election of our lifetime. And I don't say that lightly. On the air yesterday, I said something that I mean, and I'm going to say it again, because I'm the kind of person that I say what I mean, and I mean what I say. We have elections coming up that are so important for the future of this country. We have an election in District 19, in 20, in 22, in 21, all of these different districts. You need to know who the candidates are that are running, and you need to get out there and work for them. If you want to see change, you are the change. If you want some hope, you are the hope. Stop depending on other people to do what it is that we have to do. It's time to put down your hobbies. No more needlepoint. No more working out at the gym if it means you don't have time to do what you got to do to change this country. We can get back, and then we'll have all the free time that we need when we have true leaders up in Washington. And I'm going to tell you, and this is tough for me to say, if the District 22 is not able to get a man like Colonel Allen West elected, I give up. I'm throwing it out. I'm taking myself off the air. Because if we can't get a man like that elected, then there's no hope for this country. There's no hope at all. And I believe that we can do it. I believe we can get lots of these candidates elected. I believe there's going to be a landslide in this country if we open up our mouths and tell people that there's another way. You know, I heard my friend from South Carolina, she was quoting the Declaration of Independence. And yes, we all love the parts that we're familiar with. We love to talk about, we hold these truths to be self-evident. But you know what part nobody ever talks about? Well, about another paragraph and a half down, it says that whenever any form of government becomes destructive to those ends, It is the right of the people to alter or to abolish it, and to institute new government, laying its foundation on such principles and organizing its powers in such form as to them shall seem most likely to affect their safety and their happiness.
Amen.
The Founding Fathers were brilliant. They gave us two methods with which to do it. They gave us ballots, and that's the first line of defense. We go out there and we change them. We send home all of these incumbents who have done nothing to represent the people. They don't come to their districts, they don't talk to us, and they stop taking my calls. And then the Founding Fathers were ever so brilliant, and I don't care how this gets painted by the mainstream media, I don't care if this shows up on YouTube, because I am convinced that the most important thing the Founding Fathers did to ensure me my First Amendment rights was they gave me a Second Amendment. And if ballots don't work, bullets will. I've never in my life thought that the day would come where I would tell individual citizens that you are responsible for being the militia that the Founding Fathers designed. They were very specific. You need to be prepared to fight tyranny, whether it comes from outside or whether it comes from inside. And we are at a moment in history where I have a president who has declared to the entire world that he cannot secure my borders, that he cannot get rid of people who don't belong in this country, which means he cannot do his job. And when you cannot do your job, you gotta go home. The only way he goes home is in 2012 with ballots. And before that, we better stop this runaway train. So the only way we stop it is by getting majorities in Congress that reflect the will of the people and not the will of the elite. If we don't move in this election and amnesty is given to 20 million plus undocumented Democrats, it's over. You've got to do it now. This is the standoff. When I say I'll put my microphone down on November 2nd if we haven't achieved substantial victory, I mean it. Because at that point, I'm going to go up into the hills of Kentucky. I'm going to go out into the Midwest. I'm going to go up in the Vermont and New Hampshire outreaches. And I'm going to gather together men and women who understand that some things are worth fighting for and some things are worth dying for. So I need you to promise me one thing. I want you to get up every morning. I want you to hit your knees and ask the Lord for guidance and ask him for his protection for this magnificent nation. And then I want you to say to yourself, what's July 4th, 2011 going to look like in my country? And what do I need to do today to make sure I'm standing on the corner of Oakland Park Boulevard and Federal Highway waving a flag that says, we did it! You gotta be involved. I thank you for coming. I thank you for the incredible support that you've given me and my radio program and so many of these candidates. I ask you to stay vigilant, stay involved. Don't let people tell you that doesn't matter, the Tea Parties are not much ado about nothing. Margaret Mead said it best. Never believe that a small group of concerned citizens cannot change the world. In fact, it's the only thing that can. God bless you, and God bless America.